Well, we are joined once again by Emily Clark. She is the creator of this week's Sound Off South Spotlight Blog of the Week, Little Scapes. Emily, you're a Furman grad, mm-hmm. and you studied art there. When did you get into art? Did it start in college, or was it before that?
It was definitely before that. My mom was a painter for a time earlier in her life, and when I was little, we were always making things. So from the earliest I can remember, we were always painting or making crafts. But then I definitely started as an art major when I came to Furman.
And you primarily focus on oil paintings. Mm-hmm. Tell me what you love about that medium, why that is your focus.
When I say that I'm an oil painter, some people say, oh, isn't that really hard? But I think it depends on what you start with. And what I love about oil paint is that it does stay wet for a long time, and I can continue to move it around so that any paint I'm adding in becomes a part of what's already there instead of just sort of layering on top.
Okay. We talked in the last segment about how some of your work focuses on a vintage theme. Mm-hmm. And we have some video of some models, I think, that you use to create some of your vintage themes. As we show that video, tell me how you pick your subject matter.
It varies. Usually it's just what sort of attracts me, what makes me happy. I know in these photos, these were some good friends of mine that agreed to come and model, and we worked with a vintage clothing store to put together these great outfits and just made these really beautiful, colorful little vintage style vignettes.
With the vintage theme, do you find there's a lot of interest in that, people looking? I mean, because it is that time period that you're talking about, the 40s and the 50s, a lot of people reminisce about that. It's mm-hmm. kind of a romantic period. A lot of interest in it?
Absolutely. And that's usually people's reaction. They come in and take a look, and they either say, oh, that looks just like my mother or my grandmother. Or if they didn't live in that era, they're like, oh, that looks like a television show I've seen. And they start to reminisce about those time periods and how glamorous they are.
Apart from the vintage, what other kinds of things do you paint?
Oh gosh, I paint just about anything. I mean, when you've done about 400 pieces, you're searching for subjects everywhere. So I've painted landscapes, little still lives. I do a lot of babies and engagement photos. I love portraits the most, I think.
Neat, because you get to kind of depict what's going on in a person's life at that time.
Mm-hmm, absolutely.
We talked earlier about, and you just mentioned 400 pictures or paintings. You paint a painting every day, six mm-hmm. days a week, and that's the focus of your blog. Mm-hmm. When you do that, what is the process for starting a painting and getting it finished in a day?
Well, it's pretty much the same as doing a painting over a long period of time. I pick a subject, whatever that might strike me that day, and just start laying it out on the canvas. And once I get it where I like it, just sort of layering on paint. And doing it in a day, the technique is the same as doing it over a longer period of time, just a lot faster.
A lot faster. Well, you brought some work, and I want to go ahead and show this. Let's start with this first piece, if you can hold it up for the camera there.
Yeah, sure can.
This, I think you told me, is a painting of a family photograph.
Mm-hmm. This was actually a daily painting, one that I did in a day, and this was one of the first ones I did from the family photographs. And this one is actually my grandmother holding my mom when she was a baby. And it's definitely one of my favorites.
That's a neat one. I like that. And probably brings back a lot of memories for your mom and your grandmother when they get to see this.
Absolutely.
All right, let's go ahead and hold up the next one.
All right.
I'll put this one up. Yeah, that's fine. Let's see what you got here.
These are a couple newer ones. This was, I think, a vintage Coke ad. But I love the bright colors and the sort of teenagers sitting around gossiping.
Like that never happens, right?
Absolutely.
And this is actually not a canvas that you're using here, is it?
It's a canvas, but then it's laid over with butcher paper. I always like to start with a color or some different surface other than white so that I don't feel like I'm just covering up what's back there, but I can use the background as part of the piece.
Okay, let's take a look at the last one that you brought. Another vintage one, I see.
This is. And this is actually one of my newest series for my vintage show coming up. This is a good friend of mine mm-hmm. Who, in that photo shoot, we saw some photos from. This was, we dressed her up in vintage 50s clothes.
Looking at a thing from the past there.
Yep. She had records, and we had this great vintage couch here, so it was a fun piece to do.
All right. Well, the last thing I want to ask you about is you do have a gallery here.
I do.
Tell us where that's at.
I am down right in the middle of Falls Park. It's an area called Art Crossing. There's a whole group of artists that we all work down there. It's a great little community. But we have our studios open most days of the week, Tuesday through Saturday, and we're usually open the first Friday of the month as well.
And probably a very inspirational area to paint in.
It is. It's beautiful.
All right, Emily, thank you so much for being here. We've enjoyed it today.
Thank you very much.
If you'd like to check out more of Emily's blog, Littlescapes, head over to soundoffsouth.com. Look for the spotlight box in the center of the page. While you're there, check out the links to the other blogs from the Upstate and the Carolinas.